Welcome back, everyone. You might remember that about 6 or so months ago, I demonstrated using Evoto.AI for the first time. Evoto is a professional AI photo editor that allows you to perform routine tasks rather quickly and then sync those edits to other photos or save presets and apply the same edits later to a photo that's similar. So if you're a headshot photographer, you could make up a headshot preset that you like and then apply that to all your photos, and it really will speed up your workflow. Since I made that video, I started using Evoto and incorporating it into my workflow, and it's really sped up my process so that I'm not spending an hour per image, I'm only spending minutes per image. And I think that's what's great about the software, is it really will help us, as well as AI in general, to just do our jobs a lot quicker. And Evoto has sponsored this video today. And in this video, I'm going to share with you some of the latest features that they've added to the software. The first one that I want to talk about today is the stray hair removal tool. So I'm going to come down here into the hair section and just watch these flyaways from the fan that we had blowing in our model Colleen's face. And I'm going to pull this slider to the right, and almost instantaneously, you're going to see those flyaways go away. I'm going to zoom in here to 100% so you can see it up close. Here it is before, and here it is after. Now, there are two sub-sliders in this section. The first one is within figure outline. So that means that it's going to remove flyaways inside of the exterior hairline, if you will. So here it is. I'm going to pull down a little bit. Here it is with that turned off. And here it is with that turned on. So you can see immediately how it took away those flyaways that were there inside of the outline of the hair. Then the other slider is beyond the figure outlines, and it's just like what you would think it was. If I pulled it back here to the left, you'll see that all those flyaways are back. And if I pulled it to the right, you'll see that they're all gone. So that's really how this tool works, and I'm sure this is going to save you guys a lot of time as you're doing your retouching. The next thing I want to show you is the red vein removal tool. So I'm going to zoom in here even to 200% on Colleen's eyes, and I'm going to go up here to the eye section, and we're going to remove the red veins or the veins from her eyes. When I was working with a beauty client for the first time around 10 years ago, this was a commercial beauty client, they told me that one of the things that separated more professional retouching than the retouching that I was doing at the time was having all of the blood vessels taken out of the whites or the scarla of, I believe that's what it's called, of the eye. And so now Evoto is going to help you do that really quickly here. So we're just going to come down to remove red veins. I'm going to pull it over to the right and let go. And before I could even say let go, it had finished its work. So here it is before, and here it is after. And you'll see how all those veins are gone. You can also brighten up the eyes in this section if you'd like to. Here it is before, and here it is after. So we're just adding a little bit of polish to our image. And that's really what this software is great at doing, adds the polish and gets it done really quickly. So now in the makeup section, if you come down here to the very bottom, you'll see that there are all sorts of contour presets that you can choose from just by clicking on the word contour. And I'm just going to zoom out here a little bit so that you can have more of a global appreciation of her face, if you will. I'm going to go ahead and press the first one. I added a little more definition. Here's the second one. Here's the third. Brought those cheekbones in a little bit more. Here's the fourth. A little less on the cheekbones. Here's the fifth. Now we got some more of that facial definition back in there. And here's the sixth. I think I like the fifth one the most. So I'm going to come back to that, and you can actually throttle up the opacity of that layer. By default, it's 50%. If I want to pull it up a little bit more to 100, here's what that looks like. Here's back at 50, and here's 0. So let's go ahead and keep it up there at 100. I'll zoom out now so you can see zoom to fit. I'm going to press the space bar to show you before. And here it is after. So I've just added a lot more definition there to her face and her makeup, and I think it looks fantastic. So now that we're done with this image, we're gonna sync it over to the neighboring image. And this is one of the great things about Evoto. All you have to do to sync your edits from one photo to the other is just click sync, and it does the work, and it's pretty much already done. And it is, and here it is before, and here it is after. You also could make a preset for all of these changes and apply it to pictures in the future. So if you are, let's say, a business headshot photographer, you might want to apply the same changes over and over and over again. And that's what the software is good for as well. So the next thing I want to show you are the clothing de-wrinkle sliders. So if I come over here to this photo of Ethereo, I've already done some skin retouching. Here it is before, and here it is after. But more importantly on this image, I want to show you how I'm going to bring down the wrinkles on his shirt and his pants and just make the image a little more refined. So I'm going to click over here onto the clothes and accessories touch up, and that's going to bring up this slider, and I'm going to pull the de-wrinkle clothing slider to the right. And you'll see almost instantaneously how it took away all of those wrinkles. Here it is before, and here it is after. There is, of course, a remove fine wrinkle adjustment slider. So that might be, you know, from your clients shoving their shirt into a bag and not taking care of it. Or there's going to be the coarse wrinkles, and that's going to be those larger wrinkles that are going to appear probably just from posing and that sort of thing. So those two sliders are in there, and that's great. There is one more hair feature that I want to show you, and I'm going to pull up this photo of Isabel here. And now if you come back down to the hair section, there is a slider called hair gaps. So I can pull that over to the right, and that's going to fill in that part there in her hair. We also could extend the top of her hair and make it grow a little bit with this cranial top. We could change her hairline if we wanted to, but I think less is more here, and that's going to be a good tool that you might want to use. I'm going to zoom in though to another photo because I think this feature might be more helpful sometimes on men's hair. And I've zoomed in rather close because this can be sort of a sensitive topic. I'm just going to grab the hair gap slider here and pull it over halfway. And you'll see the changes happen there in the front of his hair. Here it is after, here it is before. And we're just making a significant difference there to fill in the hair. So anyway, guys, I hope that helped and made sense. I think Evoto is a really good software to use to speed up your workflow. If you'd like to check it out, please click on the link in the description to save on your subscription. If you have any questions or comments, please leave that below. And as always, have a great day. And I'll talk to you soon.